We're in the kitchen of Paragon in Kozhikode, and we're watching the making of the chicken biryani here. We've got the chicken happening in that pot. We've got the rice coming to a half boil in this pot. And behind me, we've got the fire that's being ready to cook that chicken biryani on dum. This is one episode you want to watch till the very end. A complete bite of that pan-fried mussels. Get the masala, get that chicken and the rice in one bite. This sort of biryani that you can have a conversation with. I'm in the heart of Kozhikode on Kannur Road, and I'm here to visit an establishment that's held fort for the last 8 decades, for 80 years. Set up in 1939 as one of the oldest restaurants, or perhaps the oldest restaurants in Kerala, Paragon has evolved from a restaurant to a hallowed culinary institution in this part of the country. So I'm here with Mr. Sumesh, who's the force behind Paragon Restaurant.
Maybe.
Paragon, of course, is a culinary institution in Kerala and beyond the borders of Kerala today.
Right.
But when you started in 1939, it was your grandfather.
Grandfather and dad.
Who started it.
They together.
And yeah. In 1939, there were perhaps not too many restaurants in this part of the country.
Not, never. I mean, a handful of them. Yeah. All over Kerala. Just a handful of them. And we were restaurant as well as bakery then.
A restaurant and a bakery.
Bakery, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Now we are moved into Paragon as a restaurant. We want the customer who walks in, not just having the food and going out, but I tell them that every customer should be touched. Like, you know, he should have that something, the food should touch him. So that's the idea.
So speaking of the food, yeah. So what are some of the iconic dishes?
Not just a few. Paragon is known as variety. Too many specialties, like a prawn dry fry, fish moli, chicken dry fry. But when you talk about one particular thing, I would recommend you right away is our chicken biryani.
The chicken biryani.
Yeah. Let's go and see what's happening at the chicken biryani.
Lovely. So we're going to go into the kitchens here at Paragon and watch the making of that legendary chicken biryani from scratch. Let's go into the kitchens here at Paragon. Let's go.
Yeah.
Up to you. Thanks. This is a large restaurant and therefore a large kitchen. Good evening, Chef. How are you?
Welcome to the kitchen. I am fine.
Thank you very much. So this is Chef Vijay Pillai. So he's the chef responsible for the biryanis.
Yes.
Lovely. Let's go in and take a look at that chicken biryani.
Leg on chicken.
Leg on chicken. So it begins with the chicken.
Yeah.
And the special chicken, the white leghorn chicken that goes into the making of the biryani here at Paragon.
It's more of a country chicken flavor.
More of a country chicken
flavor. It's not like broiler.
This is a chicken that's raised for eggs.
Eggs.
And
yeah.
When it reaches a certain maturity, it is then harvested
for the flesh. Yeah. Yeah.
So it's only the chicken now in this.
Yes.
And how much chicken is there in this?
140 biryani.
140 biryani.
Biryani. Yeah.
And how much chicken would that be?
Around 20 kilo.
20 kilo.
20 kilo.
All right. So now the onions will go into it.
Right.
Oh, that's a lot of onions. And then the tomato. The takali.
Vilthulli. Garlic.
This is the garlic.
Garlic. So just chopped garlic.
Yeah.
You can smell the pungent aromas of the garlic and of that onion.
Crushed green chili.
Crushed green chili.
Green chili.
That's the ginger.
Ginger.
The chicken is submerged under the onions, the tomatoes, the crushed garlic, the crushed ginger, and the green chilies.
Curd.
Some lemon juice. Fantastic. So this biryani, Sumesh, is a talisheri style biryani, is it?
Actually, this is a fusion of talisheri and a lot of our input is gone in.
So tell me, so what is different between a typical talisheri biryani and your biryani?
That's the Paragon secret.
Some salt. Akha salt. Coriander powder. Some turmeric. pepper, the black pepper, fennel powder, some water. Time for the biryani to come alive on that stove. So that meat with the onions, with the tomato, the chilies, the ginger, the garlic, and the spices that went into it are now coming together for the making of that Paragon Chicken Biriyani. So I'm told the chicken with this masala, with all the spices, will now cook for half an hour. And what they've also done is they've got some of the coconut being burnt here, because that coconut is a starter for the wood-fired stove there, where the biryani will enter its final stage of cooking on dab. That's a very eco-mindful way of getting your fuel. So there's no firewood used here, only coconut shells. So all these coconuts are used in your kitchens anyway.
Of course.
So now we have the water for the rice being boiled. This is the rice that will go, that will meet that chicken masala to finally make that Paragon chicken biryani. So chef, what has gone into this?
The ghee, water, and the
cardamom.
And salt.
This is a kitchen that's hot temperature-wise. I can feel my sinuses open. As the masala here for that chicken biryani cooks, the onions will turn to a light brown sort of a color. So chef, this will cook for how long?
Half an hour.
So after about 15-20 minutes, some more things will go in. The fried onions, the coriander.
Yes. And our special biryani masala.
And your special biryani masala. That is the secret.
That is the secret.
This is a kaima rice.
Yeah, the so small rice.
This rice is washed. Yes. Is it soaked also? Is it soaked?
No.
Just washed.
Just washed.
This rice is certainly aromatic.
Gentle. Yeah, that's what makes the Malabar, typical Malabar biryani, unique in general. The rice is like, you know, aged for 2-3 years, and there are special dealers who gives it to us, because if it's not really aged properly, it kind of gets a little mushy.
So this rice will now get half cooked.
Now it'll get half cooked.
Half cooked.
Half cooked.
What is that that went in?
It's milk and carrot.
Milk and carrot. Ah, I think we should watch this biryani being cooked. We may miss some of the ingredients. So there's some milk that went in along with the carrot. What is this?
Ghee.
So how much milk went into it?
30 ml.
Of milk?
Milk.
So the rice is coming to a gentle boil. It's being stirred to make sure that all the aromas of the cardamom, of that ghee, all of that gets soaked up, gets absorbed by the rice. You know, we enjoy the biryani, but the effort that goes into it, the labor that goes into it, is incredible. I mean, he's been doing this for the last 30 minutes and he'll do it for another 15 minutes. And he does that many times over in a single day, just so that you and I can enjoy that plate, that delicious plate of biryani. I will let you do it, sir. Coriander.
Mint.
So that coriander and mint, that gives it that aroma. And then the most essential ingredient for that biryani here, which is the brista or the fried onions. This is?
The masala.
This is worth its weight in gold, because this is the biryani masala that goes into the making of the biryani. I can smell some coriander powder, maybe some cinnamon or cassia, I'm not sure. Is there some coriander in it, chef?
Sorry, there is no coriander in it.
Is there some cloves in it?
Yes.
There's some cloves in it. How many ingredients go into it? How many?
Nine
ingredients. The nine ingredients that go into this. Chef Pillai is holding his cards close to his chest. He said there are nine ingredients that go into that, but I will not part with that recipe for my life. So the masala for that biryani is now ready. The chicken is half cooked. All the spices have gone into it, the last. And now this will be placed on dum to meet the rice. So as you can see, the fire here has died down, and all that you have now for the most part are the burning embers of the coconut shells. So this is half cooked now. So now the rice goes on.
Yeah.
So how much rice for 20 kilos of meat?
20 kilo rice.
20 kilo rice. So it's a 1:1 ratio. There's some ghee that's going into the rice.
The garnish.
Oh, some of the garnish. So this is the fried onions. I can see some coriander, some raisins, some cashew, some mint also. The rice is cooked to that perfect springiness. As he's ladling the rice on top, you can almost see that rice spring up. So he applies some pressure on the top layer of the rice just so that the rice packs itself well and it cooks slowly on the dump. So there's a maida that's going on the rim of the vessel to seal the lid. So the biryani has now entered its final stage of cooking, which is a dum cooking. As you can see, the coconut shells, the coconut embers have now been placed on top of the biryani pot and also around. This will ensure that the biryani will cook evenly on all sides, from the bottom, from the top, and also along the sides. And this pot will be unveiled after an hour of slow cooking on dum to reveal that chicken biryani here at Paragon. So this chicken biryani has been on dum for the last 1 hour, and now we are ready to unveil, to open that special chicken biryani here at Paragon.
Paragon special biryani.
The Paragon special biryani. That's a special Paragon chicken biryani. When you look at this biryani here, after it's unveiled, after that 1 hour dum cooking, all that you see is the white rice. Speckled with bits of carrots, you see some cardamom, that's all that you see. You can now see the flavors of the biryani come alive, and you can now smell of this beautiful smelling biryani here at Paragon. You can see that line of masala that's trapped in between the layers of rice in this biryani. And that's the meat that's being cooked right at the bottom. So as you can see, the biryani is being served, is being plated. So you have first the piece of meat, two pieces of meat for a full portion of biryani, and some of that masala before that plate is finished with the rice that is without the masala.
Exactly.
Right? So I'm going to be tasting some biryani upstairs, but I can't wait to dig into this fresh biryani, this pot of biryani that's just been unveiled. So just taste the rice first, just by itself.
Yeah. Then you slowly...
You can certainly taste some of that ghee in that rice.
Exactly. Yeah.
So you take some of the masala next.
Yeah.
That rice is enlivened by that masala of that chicken. White leghorn chicken. So this chicken is almost pink, this white leghorn. It's so hot that you can barely eat it, but it's like the forbidden fruit. You've just seen that biryani being cooked and you want to go at it right away. Sumesh, I think I have the perfect bite here. I've got the rice, I've got the
meat inside it.
The meat inside it somewhere, and then I've got that masala.
Exactly.
Right? I like the bite of the meat.
That's what it is.
I think I'm going to spend some more time with this chicken biryani at the table. So let's go to the table here at Paragon and taste the Paragon biryani, of course, and some other dishes too. We've just watched that chicken biryani being made. I can't wait to taste it, to spend some more time with that biryani. That biryani has spent the last 2 hours being cooked here in the kitchens at Paragon. It's only fair that we spend some time with that biryani on the table. But before that, we're going to taste some of the other specialties that this restaurant is known for. grape lime.
Sweet and spicy raw mango salad.
Sweet and spicy raw mango salad. So you make a beginning with some raw mango salad just to get the juices flowing. I love that sour sweet bite of the raw mango, punctuated by that heat from the green chili that's a part of the salad. And the crunch of the carrots. And if that chili gets to you, you find some respite in the grape lime juice, I suppose. It's an interesting flavor. Pan-fried mussels. So this is the kalumakaya minus the kallu. So you only got the kaya of the kalumakaya in this. Tamarind fish. So this is an innovative dish here at Paragon, and this is a dish that came highly recommended. So I said we should try this. The prawns dry fry. I love the size of these prawns. Crab Bhumika. A pan-fried squid. We're in Kozhikode by the sea, so we're bound to have plenty of seafood in this Gourmet On The Road series here in Kozhikode. Lovely. So this is a herbal extract, the padimugam. When you're indulging in all the seafood, balancing it out with something like this, at least makes you feel good inside. But let's begin now with that prawn dry fry, which is a classic Malabar dish. And this is a dish that they do extremely well at Paragon. I'm going to also get some of that masala. Get some of the curry leaf too, the toasty herbaceous notes of the curry leaf. When you see a dish like this, you want to make sure that you get a little bit of everything on your plate to complete all the flavors. There's a reason why the dish has some chili, there's a reason why the dish has some curry leaf. It doesn't just impart flavor to the dish when the dish is being cooked, but it also needs to impart flavor to your palate. And that's only possible when you eat everything that's on your plate. Without any further ado, let's go for the prawn here. We're in Kerala, we're in Kozhikode, so you will of course taste the fragrance of the coconut oil that this prawn has been cooked in. And then you taste that lingering sweetness of the prawn, crusted in the spices and in that rice powder that's napping this piece of prawn. This prawn is cooked to textbook perfection. It's seasoned just right. It's got that perfect crunch and that yielding bite. This prawn is cooked to textbook perfection. The best part of a prawn is also in that prawn head, because that's where you have all the flavor of the prawn that's trapped inside that prawn head. This is a delicious start to the meal here at Paragon. I think next we're going to go for the kalumakaya fry. So these are the mussels that have been fried, that have been tossed with plenty of onion, some curry leaf, also some chili. Taste the toasty sweetness of the onion and that gentle lilt of that mussels. I think the mussel by itself is more of a textural delight, but the mussel needs to be partnered with something interesting to make for that wholesome, delicious bite. And I think that's what they do here with the onions. I think the onions here that these mussels have been pan fried in help elevate the flavor. So when you taste the mussels, the pan-fried mussels, you want to make sure that you go for the mussels all right, but make sure you've got a generous helping of the onions, perhaps also some curry leaf, the karuve pile, and put together a complete bite of that pan-fried mussels. I love that. It's a play of flavors and textures in my mouth. So I've got the soft springiness of the mussels, I've got that sweet crunch of the onions, and then that toasty lilt of that curry leaf. I think there's also some pepper in there somewhere. So you definitely feel the gentle heat of that pepper that's there in that pan-fried mussels. I think let's move from one pan fry to the next, and this is the pan fried squid, or the kundal as they call it in Malayalam. So you've got the calamari, which is again tossed with the
dried onions, the curry leaf, and of course that green chili, the pacha melagu. I think I'm going to get more of the onion. I think we'll taste the squid first just by itself. I think the squid is cooked just right. It has that slight springy bite. But squid by itself is quite neutral in its flavor. So you need the masala to savor this bite of the squid. I'm told Paragon prides itself on its innovative approach to traditional flavors. And somewhere along the way, they also play a bit with the flavors, with the ingredients. And this is one such dish at Paragon. This is the tamarind fish. So this is the kingfish in the tamarind fish preparation here at Paragon. So what you have is a darn of the kingfish or the ayakora, which is tossed in this tamarind sauce. That tamarind fish takes your palate in a whole new direction. This tamarind fish is a medley of tastes on your palate. So you of course taste the tartness of the tamarind. I think there's something sweet that's gone into balance against the tamarind, so perhaps some jaggery. And there's also the warmth of ginger that you taste in this dish. And what I like is that this fish is as fresh as it can get. You can see how it flakes away. You can see the pristine whiteness of the fish. And this fish has been lightly fried before being tossed in that innovative tamarind sauce or masala that they have invented here in Paragon. You know, my plate's beginning to look like a bit of a mess, but when you're tasting great food, you don't mind the mess. The more the mess, the tastier the food that you're eating. And for the last of my appetizers here, this is the crab Bhumika. I'm told this is again an invention of the restaurant. I think this is a restaurant that prides itself on its approach to Malabar cuisine. So you have traditional flavors, but then you have subtle, interesting, clever accents to these flavors, which I think draws you to these dishes a little more. Let's taste the crab Bhumika here. So this is one way of going for the crab. But I think the other way, and if you want to really get at all that masala, is to just bite into it. I love the size of these sea crabs. They're so soft that you can actually chew into it and swallow it entirely. So when you bite into your crab like this, you get a flavor of all that masala that's napping it. You want to taste the sweet meat of that crab along with that masala. Paragon is hugely popular with the locals here. And as we can hear from the sounds around me, Paragon is popular with Kozhikodeans of all ages. So there's a fair bit of coriander that's gone into this crab, and you taste the fresh flavor with the coriander, and of course there's some pepper that's gone into as well. So you've got the lingering heat of the pepper that's napping this crab, this sea crab. And what's interesting about the masala of this crab Bhumika is also that it's got green peppercorn, so it gives you the heat of the pepper, but in a very gentle sort of manner. So it's a sort of heat that gently creeps up on your palate. Some of the padimugam as we now wait for the main course to arrive on our table. Avoli moilee, oh fantastic. Fish mango curry. Mutton varthiyathu. The vellappam. And the parotta, Malabar parotta. So we have our main course on the table. And we have the avoli moilee, or the whole pomfret moilee. Oh, lovely. That's a fresh white pomfret, the avoli, cooked in that moilee curry. Oh, this pomfret is hot to the touch. You can certainly taste the creamy richness of that coconut milk. And this is a sort of dish that you should enjoy with a velappam. I love the lacy edges of this velappam. I think it's a textbook velappam. I think what you need to do is get some of that curry on your fish and enjoy it with that appam. You need to taste the fish with that Moilee curry. The mellow soothing flavors of that coconut milk punctuated by slivers of the onion and the slight bite of the green chili that's perhaps gone into the cooking, the making of this Meen Moilee. Now this is my favorite part of the appam, the center, which works like a sponge to soak up all the flavors of the curry. I think it's time to perk things up with this sear fish mango curry or the ayakora mango curry. This, I'm told, is again a very popular dish here at Paragon. This is a dish that's been on the menu for over 20 years. So I've got the fish. I also want some of that mango. So these are slivers of raw mango that is used to flavor this curry. I think I'm going to taste the fish first without the mango. That fish has imbibed the sourness of the raw mango, and I also tasted a sliver of the ginger. And you also have the ulli, the tiny onions, the shallots in this curry. That onion is not completely broken down by the curry, so it still has some bite intact. I'm going to go for this dish with some more of that appam. That soft, spongy center of the appam, because I think it's such a great bread to mop up that curry. The tart flavor notes of this mango curry here at Paragon. I think it's time now to try the fish with a sliver of the raw mango and also some curry leaf for good measure. You know, when you taste the raw mango, you're expecting to taste the sourness of the mango. But you taste just the slightest into the sourness, because that raw mango has served its purpose in the curry by imbuing the fish with its tartness. So all that remains on the raw mango is the gentlest of sour notes that you taste. But other than that, the tartness of that raw mango is completely imbued in this curry and in the fish, in the ayakora. I love the crunch of the ulli. And try now the mutton Varthiyathu. This mutton preparation certainly looks like an indulgent one. I'm told that the name refers to the fact that the mutton, the onions are roasted for a while, and hence the varati, which means to roast over a period of time. I've got the chop here, so that piece of mutton is soft. It peels away effortlessly from the bone. This mutton is as soft, as tender as that. It's cooked to textbook perfection. That mutton is cooked beautifully well. It's rendered beautifully into this Varthiyathu, into this preparation. This is certainly a dish that will benefit from being mopped up with the parota, a Malabar parota. Oh, this parota is soft and flaky. I want to get some of that onion gravy. The mutton has been slow cooked with the onions for hours, and that's what results in this indulgent preparation of the mutton Varthiyathu. You taste the sweetness of the onions, there's some tomatoes that have gone into it. You taste the bite of the ginger and the flavor, the savory meaty notes of the fat from the meat as it has rendered into the gravy during its slow cooking. This is a tasty dish, no doubt, but certainly an indulgent one at that. There's a deliciously satisfying bite right there.
Lovely. Thank you. Smelling the mellow, fragrant aroma of that kaima rice. You see all this white rice on top. But this rice is only a veil to the flavors that lurk beneath the surface of this Talashiri style biryani that's made in the Paragon way. The biryani in this part of the country is served with a smattering of accompaniments. So first you have a sweet pickle, and this is the date pickle, and then you have a hot pickle, which is the naranga achar, and then you have a chutney, a coarsely ground coconut chutney. I'm sure there's some chili flakes in there somewhere. And then you have a raita of sorts called the tairuli here. You can see some cucumber, a lot of green chili slices, and then some papadam. So I can't wait to get to this biryani. So first, some of the white rice. And as you cut through the white rice, you begin to see the layers that emerge of the meat, of course, and that masala. Some cashew. I want to taste first that rice without any of that masala. I just want to taste the flavor of that rice just by itself. You know, that rice barely has any masala that's clinging to it, but yet there's a certain sense of fulfillment that you get when you taste that rice just by itself. The flavor of the ghee, the rice is absorbed. The flavor of the spices that it's been cooked in, you had some cardamom and you had some of the other herbs that went into the rice, and that gives that rice a very mellow, gentle flavor. What do you want to do with a biryani like the Talashiri style biryani is you want to progress in the flavor depth. You want to start with the white rice. You want to taste that rice just by itself with its mellow, lingering flavors. And then you want to gradually oomph up the flavor quotient by taking a little more of the masala. And that's what I've done with this rice as it gets ready to meet my palate. That masala is a flavor bomb. I haven't tasted the meat yet, but I can taste the flavor of the chicken in that masala already. That masala has absorbed all the juices of that meat, of that chicken, while it was cooked in that for nearly an hour. And that sweet savouriness that comes from the fried onions. And now to taste some of the meat of that white leghorn chicken. So this isn't the broiler chicken, but this is the white leghorn chicken. What you want to do is get the masala, get that chicken and the rice in one bite. You taste the spicy sweetness of the masala thanks to the fried onions. I also got a flavor pop from some kismis or the raisin that I just bit into. Now this is the sort of biryani that you can linger over. This sort of biryani that you can have a conversation with. And then you have these accompaniments that come into play. So take some of the date pickle. Mix that into your biryani. We're in Malabar, and that's how they relish the biryani here. They like to savor their biryani at different levels. You begin first only with the rice. Then you begin with the rice and the masala. Then you do the rice, the masala, and the chicken. And then you move on to the date pickle. And when you feel you've had a little too much sweetness, you move along to the hot pickle. And in this case, it's a naranga achar, a lemon pickle. You got the tart bite of the lemon, and then the bitterness that comes from the lemon rind. Go back to some of the meat, just in case you want some respite from the heat of the pickle. And then go with some of this coconut chutney. Coconut chutney with a biryani. Who would have thought of it? But that's the way you relish the biryani if you're in this part of the country. Mm. You know that coconut chutney with that chili, with that mint, in a manner of speaking, actually helps refresh your palate. I got some of the rice with that masala. And also what you want to do is go for some of that raita, that Thai roli, with the cucumber, with some chilies. And what they also do with the biryani here is enjoy it with the papadam. So you take some of the papadam, scrunch that up into your biryani and go for a nice crunchy bite. You know, I've never tasted biryani with papadam before. I think what these accompaniments do is they provide layers of texture, a layer of flavor to add to your enjoyment of the talasheri style biryani. I think that's what these accompaniments do. So what you can do is go for a bit of the sweet, go for a bit of the hot, go for a bit of the coconut chutney, wash it down with some of that raita, pep things up with the crunch of the papadam to find something new, to enjoy something new in every bite of this biryani. You know, we've come full circle here at Paragon. We came in, we watched the making of the chicken biryani, and we're finally tasting the chicken biryani. I think what makes Paragon extremely appealing, and perhaps also the reason for its massive fan following over the years, is that here's a restaurant that's not just stood the test of time for 8 decades, but this is a restaurant that has constantly evolved. That has constantly evolved, not just in the space that it is, but in its offerings. Paragon has succeeded in taking the offerings of the land, in taking the offerings of the Malabar region and giving it its own spin, thereby making each dish uniquely different, uniquely special and endearing. And I think that's where Paragon has hit upon a winning formula. So if you're in this part of the country, definitely make sure you stop by at Paragon and check out not just the talasheri biryani, but also some of the other signature delight. I'm confident you'll leave delighted. So until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating. I'm going to go back to my talasheri biryani with that sweet date pickle. Hope you enjoyed this Gourmet on the Road episode. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share and leave a comment below. Happy eating!